All right, my friends, until you know this one thing, you doggone better not quit your crappy old job. This one thing is simple, your expenses. I was working with a client today, good guy, I love this guy, up in Maryland. He's not leaving because in Maryland, if your income is below a certain threshold, they don't really tax you that badly. Same with California, same with most states. Most blue states, actually, they don't tax that bad if your income is below a certain threshold. The threshold is not low. In this case, it's like, I mean, he was making $90,000 a year in retirement and hardly paying any tax. Anyway, all right, so we're running this Right Capital software, and he had his expenses down, as most engineering types do, to the dollar with a spreadsheet, 26-page spreadsheet. It's all, man, I love it. It's all good. Anyway, so we're looking at Right Capital. I'm like, something's not flying here because there's no way he was spending as much money as Right Capital was saying. And no, he inputted this stuff, so I knew that his inputs are wrong. It's user error, as it is usually the case, by the way. And so we're just kind of going through the numbers. And, you know, what he thought, he said $85,000 a year is expenditures. And Right Capital, he had $85,000 a year on top of his mortgage, on top of his health care, on top of his income taxes, his homeowners insurance, all that, and auto insurance. I said, no. You know, we got to reduce all that. So your $85,000 a year is all in, all inclusive. And initially I was thinking, maybe he's using a financial advisor who's saying he needs 80% of his pre-retirement income. But, you know, it's like, that's not going to, that doesn't, I don't get why we're thinking this. But anyway, point being, and he does have a mortgage, and he's going to keep his, well, actually, he's not going to keep, what he's doing, he's going to pay the mortgage off in the next 6 months, which is good. Talked to another guy today earlier. I said, yeah, man, they're going to move, they're going to buy a house, and they're going to mortgage it. It just depends on the circumstance. It really, really does. In this case, the guy is going to pay it off. He basically, instead of doing Roth conversions, he's going to take two distributions from his IRA. In this case, it's a TSP. Half of this year, by the end of this year, and the other half at the end of next year, at the beginning of next year, and pay off the mortgage. That's going to free him about $2,000 a month, for which he can now use to do other things with, to save. And essentially, instead of doing Roth conversions, he's using that money to pay off his mortgage. I think it's a great strategy. The people I was dealing with earlier today, on the other hand, they're going to take a mortgage, all right, to buy a house for $300,000. It's going to cost them $1,500 a month. But instead of paying it off all at once, they're just going to pay it off $1,500 a month. Now, they need about $90,000 a year as well, when all said and done, to include income taxes. They're just pulling it from their 401k, their IRA. $90,000, you know, would include taxes. That puts them right at the lower end of the 12%, or the higher limits of the 12% tax bracket. It's freaking perfect, man. Yeah, so both, it's like these guys are identical. Both these guys are going to be no more, their effective tax rate over the course of their retirement is going to be about 13 to 15%. You just can't shake a stick at that, man. And both are including state income taxes, which I think the software is a little bit higher than what will actually be. Anyway, but the point being is, if you don't have your expenses down, or if the software isn't calculating your expenses correctly, it's going to screw you up, man. So just because you have a spreadsheet, that's great. But if the spreadsheet isn't being if the information from the spreadsheet is being extrapolated incorrectly to the software that you're using, you got to fix that. And we're able to fix it for this guy. Actually, both of these people this morning, and they're both fine, man. There's just no other way around that. Both don't need to take an exorbitant amount of risk. Both gonna have enough cushion in case the markets tank. It's just perfect. But again, it all comes to expenses. It all comes to expenses. So make sure your expenses are right before you engage in, you know, telling your HR that you're leaving. Because if your expenses are wrong, hey, you might not retire when you should. If your expenses are right, and then you might say, hey, I could retire. So you got to get your expenses right. All right, we'll see you.